안녕하세요. 오늘은 LG화학의 신학철 부회장님의 강연을 가지고 왔습니다. 신학철 부회장님은 3M 한국지사에 평사원으로 입사해 미국 본사의 수석 부회장까지 오른 입지전적인 인물인데요. 이번 강연에서 그는 친환경 기술의 현재를 소개해 주셨습니다. LG화학에서 어떤 신기술에 집중하고 있는지 그 부분을 중점적으로 보시면 좋을 것 같고요. 그럼 강연 시작하겠습니다.
As you see there, there are a lot of geopolitics in play at the moment. As you know, the United States decided to leave the Paris Agreement for the second time in 8 years. That happened several months ago, as you all know. While this move of the United States had been somewhat anticipated, we think it still carries a significant weight all around the world. However, despite the administration's withdrawal from Paris Agreement, many U.S. organizations are choosing to redouble their commitment to combat climate change, including America is All In, that's the name of the initiative in the United States, which is a coalition of over 8,000 mayors, governors, and business leaders who continue to push forward with climate commitments. Globally, the U.S. withdrawal has not triggered a mass exodus yet from the Paris Agreement by other nations. In Europe, while the Corporate Sustainability Reporting Directive, or CSRD, forces challenges, many public and private entities are rallying to defend it. China is charging ahead with unprecedented level of investment in renewable energy. And recently, China formed a joint front with the European Union, who is loosely replacing the role of the United States in this endeavor to cajole China and work with China to fulfill the notion of decarbonization, to continue to charge ahead with climate commitment. In the meanwhile, International Energy Agency predicts that the global clean tech market will triple to $2 trillion by 2035. For this economic reason and other reasons, countries now realize that their future depends on their ability to transit into clean energy. Despite these fragmented market approaches, one thing is quite certain: clean tech continues to evolve in ways that address the inherent limitations of renewable energy, its intermittency, its inefficiency in certain contexts, and its challenges in achieving economic viability at scale. Three technologies in particular are emerging as game changers: hydrogen, small modular reactor, or SMR, which many of you are already familiar with. The one which is probably less widely understood and known is long-duration energy storage, or LDES. LDES represents a significant leap beyond conventional energy storage systems. While traditional lithium-ion-based ESS has been rapidly commercialized, it is typically limited to providing reliable discharge for around 4 hours. LDES, by contrast, can deliver electricity for 10 hours or more, which is dramatically enhancing grid stability and grid resiliency. This extended capability makes LDES especially effective in pairing with renewables such as solar, wind, and hydropower, capturing energy when it's generated and making it available precisely when it's needed. In other words, LDES helps bridge the gap between intermittent supply and consistent demand. What is more, the cost dynamics are shifting in its favor. According to a recent report, certain LDES technologies, such as thermal storage and compressed air energy storage, already exhibit lower capital cost per kilowatt hour than lithium-ion systems. For example, thermal storage averages around $232 per kilowatt hour, and compressed air at around $293. Compared to approximately $304 per kilowatt hour by lithium-ion systems. Taken together, these advances point to a future in which renewables reinforced by LDES and SMR can deliver reliable, affordable, and low-carbon energy at scale on a global basis. The rise of artificial intelligence, or AI, and the explosive growth of data centers are reshaping global capacity in electricity. Industry forecasts suggest that data centers could account for a double-digit share of national power consumption in key markets within this decade. For technology leaders, securing stable and sustainable power is no longer optional. It is essential to their business continuity and their climate commitment. This is why global technology companies are increasingly stepping ahead of governments and traditional utilities by investing directly in next-generation clean tech. For them, it is not only about meeting net zero pledges, but also about ensuring long-term access to reliable, affordable, carbon-free electricity. Take the example of Google. In collaboration with Energy Dome, the company recently invested in innovative CO2 battery technology. This system captures carbon dioxide, compresses it, and then expands it to generate power, essentially using CO2 as a closed-loop working fluid. The advantages of this technology are compelling. It offsets the intermittency of renewable power, provides continuous electricity supply for 8 to 24 hours, delivers low construction cost compared to conventional solutions, supplies round-the-clock energy with zero emissions, and avoids dependence on critical minerals. These attributes make CO2 batteries a strong contender to become a mainstream long-duration energy storage solutions around the world. More broadly, the example illustrates a critical trend. Big tech firms are becoming key catalysts in scaling up advanced clean tech, driven both by necessity and also by opportunity. If I can predict the clean tech going forward, I'd say there are five things that we must do on a global basis by any institution. I think first is to realize that climate change and climate action necessary are irreversible. You know, we can hem and haw a little bit, we can delay it a little bit, we can tinker with regulation, but at the end of the day, this has to be irreversible trend. And institutions alike, industry, government, and otherwise, has to realize this and should be prepared accordingly. Secondly, it's all about leadership. You know, whoever leads the organization, whether it's a business organization or, you know, even a government institutions, the leadership is the key in moving this forward. This is not done by consensus building or democracy, if you will. So the strong leadership to make it forward, especially at a time of slow growth, at a time of difficult economic situation, is the key. It's not going to happen without strong leadership at all level. And also, we must find a solution whereby decarbonization can coexist with growth. One may be necessary, but not sufficient without the other. We cannot just make our whole operation carbon-free and see the company go belly up, or vice versa. So this is a time that we must find the equation of the end, not the equation of either or. It's not the either or question, the growth versus decarbonization is an end. And I can tell you in LG Chem, we are proving that there are not just one, but many equations that make this end equation possible. The other thing is in all this endeavor, clean tech innovation is the only way. Technology solution, we think, is the only way to move things forward. So furthermore, importance in continuing development in clean tech innovation. AI is a huge factor in this. I think we'll have a big discussion today about how AI is affecting the clean tech. So I'll not mention too much about AI, but those are some of the things that I have in mind going forward. Just a couple more minutes. Here is LG Chem's clean tech approach. Within this clean tech global transformation, LG Chem is accelerating our own transition toward low carbon, high value businesses as the foundation of sustainable growth. This is not merely a matter of choice, it is a matter of survival. Traditional chemical companies, with their energy intense and carbon heavy operations, face an increasingly unforgiving reality. To remain competitive, we must fundamentally reimagine our business model. Let me talk about just a couple of things very briefly. The first is the dry reforming of methane, or DRM. This proprietary process converts captured CO2 mixed with methane into syngas, which can be converted into the other feedstock for plastics. We are now commercializing DRM technology, probably at scale the largest in the world. As the first company in Korea to commercialize DRM with our own technology, we are building a competitive edge that aligns with the global push for carbon neutrality. The second initiative that we have is HVO, or hydro-treated vegetable oil, produced from renewable sources such as used cooking oil. This HVO material significantly reduces greenhouse gas emissions compared with fossil fuels. We are turning this waste veggie oil into, for example, sustainable aviation fuel, bio-based naphtha, and bio-based other feedstocks. So we completed the pilot plant for this operation last year. So my key takeaway here, to conclude today's remark, first, next generation clean tech is indispensable in the age of AI. As data and computing needs accelerate, technologies such as SMR and long duration energy storage, or LDES, are proving critical to overcoming the limitations of renewables, which ensures stable and affordable power while reducing exposure to geopolitical risks in energy supply. Second, clean tech is no longer optional. It is becoming a foundation of competitiveness. From big tech to global industry leaders, companies are investing not only to achieve climate goals, but also to secure energy and economic security. This competition is shaping the future of our global economy, and it is a race in which LG Chem is determined to lead. Thank you.